the new president of USA Boxing, Tyson Lee, and we're here. Mauricio Suleiman is here at the big WBC event. You have Doug Fischer, the editor-in-chief. Hey. Have you met Tyson Lee, the new president of USA Boxing?
Oh, I have not.
Tyson?
Tyson.
Doug Fischer, nice to meet you.
He's a warrior, he's a soldier, former West Point, and now he's bringing
West Point,
bringing nice. Boxing to where it's supposed to be, the amateur, because yes. There's a lot of things that need to be fixed. So, if
That's
you're talking...
Nice blood of the sport.
The editor-in-chief of Ring Magazine. If you're talking to Tyson Lee, what would... Doug Fischer, what would you tell him about the state of amateur boxing, and what would you want to see him do? Or?
You know, I'd like to see amateur boxing have a higher profile in the United States, because I remember going into the Olympics, I used to be able to turn on the TV and I could watch Pernell Whitaker fighting at the 1983 Pan American Games, and I used to see the Golden Gloves finals from New York City. I used to see it all on TV.
Well, that's why we're on this trip now, because we're going to form a relationship with the WBC, and Mauricio and I hit it off wonderfully. So, you know, now we're gonna put our two organizations together, USA Boxing and WBC, and do some great things.
Yeah, you and I are probably the same generation, but I mean, I knew who Mark Breland was long before he turned pro.
Like, I knew about winner 1984 Olympics.
But even before the Olympics, I knew who Mark Breland was. Yeah, and you knew who Holyfield was, and you knew who Melvin Taylor was.
People were waiting for him to turn pro, and that's what we have to do now.
We couldn't wait.
Yeah, we couldn't wait.
And Mark Breland was on the cover of Ring Magazine before he turned pro. I mean, actually, Breland was bigger than Mike Tyson, at least in New York City, before he turned pro, because of his amateur, because people, and that's how it was back in the day. Ray Robinson wasn't a popular, he wasn't just a popular professional fighter. He was a huge attraction as an amateur boxer. And he could, you know, winning the New York Golden Gloves, and winning the inner city finals, which is basically sort of the de facto national tournament back in the day, filled out arenas, in, not just in New York City, but in Chicago and Detroit. So it's...
Amateur programs all over the world are blossoming in Ukraine and Russia and Cuba. What do we have to do here to become glorious and amateurs again?
Well, one of the things you have to do is we have to open up, allow ourselves to open up and get some help from organizations like the WBC. We got to do a better job of marketing. Because, you know, we have a lot more competition today with all people are watching UFC and they're watching all these different things with X Games or video games. And you know, we got to do just what we're doing now. Get out there, promote the sport, and promote our fighters. And also allow some of the alumni to come back and celebrate their success. And allow them to come back and have an opportunity to impact these kids.
Thank you so much.
Thank
Good
you.
Luck.
Yes, sir.
And now we're here at this dinner. Thank you.
At this time, I mean, all of you, I hope, have ordered drinks, are free to order drinks, are free to order free drinks.
Well, that's looking skinny. Carlos Palomino in the house.
Man, I'm trying to get one to get to 147.
Your attention, please.
Come back.
No.
No talking.
So there you have it. Stay tuned. This is the one that comes and lays it back.
At this time, I would like to introduce...